Next, we have the engine that makes it all run, your power supply. As you may have figured out from the name, it's the component that supplies your whole computer with power. As we've mentioned briefly in the CPU section and the GPU section, it's important to get a power supply with sufficient strength that meets safety regulation and delivers an even flow of power to protect your valuable components. One thing you should also consider is cable management of your PC, and the power supply will play a crucial role in that. There are a few different styles of power supplies: non-modular, semi-modular, or fully modular. A non-modular power supply comes with all the cables permanently attached. You'll have everything you need, and it's usually the cheapest alternative. However, the downside is that you'll probably have cables lying around you're not using, making cable management harder. A semi-modular power supply comes with only the essential cables permanently attached. You can then attach any additional cables you need, which will result in less clutter and is a good alternative than the more expensive fully modular power supply. A fully modular power supply is as it sounds. It has no permanent cables attached. This allows you to connect the exact cables you need for the perfect cable management. However, as mentioned, it usually is the most expensive type. Installing your power supply is fairly straightforward. All you need to do is make sure that the fan is pointed in the right direction, which is outside of your case, and screw it into place. When this is done, it's time to connect all the power supplies to the various components in your PC. Most power supplies come labeled, so it's clear which cables go where, and many of the cables themselves are labeled, so you know exactly which ones to use. There are two things in your motherboard that need power: the motherboard itself and the CPU. Make sure that the right power cable is going to the right section, and you can refer to the information we talked about in the motherboard section previously. Next, you'll want to hook up the GPU if it requires any external power. And of course, as covered in the storage section, make sure you have power allocated to your drives. Now, for things you should consider when buying your power supply. Firstly, you need to find out how much power your system needs. This can be easily done using the great tool provided by the PC Part Picker, where you fill in all the component you plan to use and it will give you an estimated wattage that your system will need. If you use a power supply that's inefficient, it can strain your component and even result in shutdowns. Next step is to, of course, find a power supply that matches the wattage you need. There are two measurements: peak wattage and continuous wattage. Peak wattage is just that. It's the maximum output the power supply can handle. This stat can be a little bit misleading because you don't know how long the power supply is capable of supplying power at that rate. Continuous wattage is a better measurement, since that's what it can supply around the clock, which is an important part for a healthy computer. Lastly, you want to look for a good quality power supply. Check the certification rating and pick one up from a brand that you trust and one that meets all safety regulations.